In February, you introduced the Assault Weapons Ban and Law Enforcement Protection Act of 2007. It would regulate semi-automatic assault weapons, including weapons that have pistol grips, a forward grip, and something called a barrel shroud. Weapons with a barrel shroud would be regulated. What's a barrel shroud, and why should we regulate it?
I think the more important thing is that it also would have had banned the large capacity clips that
right.
Colin Ferguson had
but
used, and also the killer.
Okay. But I read the legislation, and it said that it would regulate barrel shrouds. What's a barrel shroud, and why should we regulate that?
The guns that were chosen back in those days were basically the guns that most gangs and criminals were using to kill our police
okay.
officers. I'm not saying it was the best bill, but that
okay.
was the best bill
they could
get out at
that particular
time. Do you know what a barrel shroud is? I actually don't know what a barrel shroud is.
Okay, because
it's
in your legislation.
I believe it's a shoulder thing that goes up.
And she wants to prevent terrorists from obtaining this rifle and is urging New York State lawmakers to pass the Anti-Terrorism and Aviation Protection Act, an act that the National Rifle Association will likely fight, claiming the right to bear arms.
Come on. This is crazy. You can't certainly use this for hunting. But some of these bullets, as you saw, have an incendiary device on the tip of it, which is a heat-seeking device. So you don't shoot deer with a bullet that size. If you do, you could cook it at the same time.
Damn it. Shit.
Time has come, America, to step up and ban these weapons. The other very important part of this bill is to ban large capacity ammunition feeding devices, those that hold over 10 rounds. We have federal regulations and state laws that prohibit hunting ducks with more than 3 rounds, and yet it's legal to hunt humans.
Once upon a time, there were 6 little hunters.
Rise and shine, Mason.
Yo, what the fuck? Get fuck's up, Cole!
Get up. Put your shit on.
Yo, this shit ain't funny, Cole!
Shut the fuck up and put that shit on!
We like to play a game.
Yes. It's very simple. You see, the hunt begins now. We're the hunters, and you're the hunted. You leave here now with a head start of as long as it takes us to eat a nice, leisurely breakfast.
If you make it to civilization, you live. If you don't, maybe God will have mercy.
Yo, Bert.
If you want to protect yourself, get a double-barrel shotgun, have the shells, a 12-gauge shotgun, and I promise you, as I told my wife, we live in an area that's wooded and somewhat secluded. I said, Jill, if there's ever a problem, just walk out on the balcony here or walk out, put that double barrel shotgun and fire 2 blasts outside the house. I promise you, whoever's ever coming in is not going to...
I do think that we can pass those. And just very briefly, to your last question, what's the efficacy of banning these magazine clips? I will tell you, these are ammunition. They're bullets. So the people who have those now, they're going to shoot them. And so if you ban them in the future, the number of these high-capacity magazines is going to decrease dramatically over time because the bullets will have been shot and there won't be any more available.
Fuck you!
Those who support the bill say even an unloaded gun is still dangerous.
There's been a lot of people that have been shot by an unloaded gun.
Hey, you! Come back here!
Well, what do you know? No more bullets.
No more bullets? Hey, laughing boy! No more bullets.
No more bullets?
Here, let me see that thing.
These new 3D printers, which can be purchased for about $1,000, allow guns to be made, perfectly functioning, firing guns, without any metal.
That punk pulled a Glock 7 on me. You know what that is? It's a porcelain gun made in Germany. Doesn't show up on your airport x-ray machines here, and it costs more than you make in a month.
You'd be surprised what I make in a month.
It's more than $1.98, I'd be very
surprised.
Hey, McLean,
don't start believing.
Well, let's just look at the assault weapons ban.
Yep.
We had one in this country for 10 years. Every single weapon used by the shooter in Connecticut would have been okay under the old assault weapons law. They were all exceptions.
Yeah, okay, so the law was flawed. Fix it.
Isn't it pretty hard to define what is an assault weapon? Because it's so easy to write around for manufacturers to create weapons that...
Well, if it can fire a lot of bullets very quickly, that's a good good place to start, okay?
And hunters
and then you
would
can
say,
argue what a lot is. Okay, let's pick it. Let's say three. If you haven't hit the deer with three shots, you're a pretty lousy shot. That deer deserves to get away. Let's get serious here.
But that would ban most pistols. That would ban most...
No, but pistols are different. You have to pull the trigger each time. An assault weapon, you basically hold it, goes... Blah, blah, blah. Whoa!
This is a ghost gun.
Okay, Ray, give me one hiding outside.
Ray!
Okay, all right. Oh, nice shooting, Tex.